नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय नेम इज जेबीएन मनीषा सिंह। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू की लॉजिस्टिक्स ट्रेंड्स एंड सप्लाई चेन रिलेशनशिप इन द फूड इंडस्ट्री इन सब्जेक्ट फूड स्टोरेज एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू नो व्हाट इज मार्केट लॉजिस्टिक्स। फिजिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द फैक्ट्री। मैनेजर चूजेस अ सेट ऑफ warehouses which is known as stocking points where you can stock your all raw materials etc. and then transportation carriers that will be deliver the goods to final destination in the desired time and at the lowest total cost. Physical distribution has now expanded into a broader concept of supply chain management. Supply chain management starts from strategically procuring the right inputs, that is raw material from and capital equipments, then converting them efficiently into finished products and dispatching them to the final destination. Market logistics planning includes four stages. First is deciding on the company's value proposition to its customer, that what on time delivery standard should we offer and what levels should we attain in ordering and billing accuracy. Then deciding on the best channel design and network strategy for reaching its customers, that should we serve directly or through intermediaries, where to source the manufacturing facilities, for what products, how many warehouses should we maintain and where should we locate these warehouses. Then developing operational excellence in sales forecasting, warehouse management, transportation management, material management, and implementing this solution with the best information system, equipments, policies, and procedures. Then supply chain for an individual firm is by the vendors, plants or ports or farms, then that raw material is transported by any transportation system. Then it will store in the warehouses. From the warehouses, they will transport it to the factory. Then from the factory, it is processed, manufactured. Then it will transferred to the warehousing again. Then from the warehouses, it will transport it to the customers. Okay, for example, if you buy a chips or packet from a shop, then the potatoes will come from the farm. They will transport it to the company's warehouse where they are stored. And then the company's warehouses, maybe within the premises of processing unit or maybe some at different location. From the warehouses, they are transported to the factory where the chips will be made from those potatoes which are stored in the warehouses. After that, these chips will be transported after the processing of chips from potato to potato chips. They are transported to the warehouses where they are stored in the package, already packaged in our packets. And then from the warehouses, they will be transported to the shops and where we will buy it easily. Then logistics defined. Logistics is the process of planning, implementing and controlling the efficient, cost-effective flow and storage of raw materials, in-process inventory, finished goods and related information from the point of origin to the point of consumption for the purpose of conforming to customer requirement. Supply chain management defined as SCM is the integration of all activities associated with the flow and transformation of goods from raw materials through to end user, as well as information flows through the improved supply chain relationships to achieve the sustainable competitive advantage. The logistics supply chain mission is getting the right goods or services to the right place at the right time and in the desired condition at the lowest cost and highest return on investment. The significance of logistics. Costs are high, that is about 10.5% of GDP domestically, about 12% of GDP internationally, a range of 4 to 30% of sales for individual firms, average about 10%, a high as 70 to 80% of sales if purchasing and production are included. Customers are more demanding of the supply chain. They desire for quick response. They desire for mass customization. An integral part of company strategy, it will generate revenue and improve the profit. Logistical lines are strengthening or lengthening local versus long distance supply. Then logistics is a key to trade and an increased standard of living. Law of comparative economic advantage applies. Logistics adds value, that is time and place utilities. Then scope of supply chain for the most firms are basically business logistics is divided into two parts, that is physical supply and physical distribution. Physical supply is material management, that is sources of supply, it will transport it to the plant operations, and then physical distribution is plant operation, plants to or operations to the customers. In the sources of supply to plant or operations of the factory, it will include the transportation, inventory maintenance, order processing, acquisition or procurement, protective packaging, warehousing, materials handling, and information maintenance. Key activities and processes, primary setting customer service goals, transportation, inventory management, location, secondary or supporting, warehousing, materials handling, acquisition, purchasing, protective packaging, product scheduling, order processing. The logistics strategies, triangle, forecasting, storage fundamentals, inventory decisions, purchasing and supply, scheduling decisions, storage decisions, then transport strategies, transport fundamentals, transport decisions, then customer service goals, the product, logistics, service and information sales, then location strategy, that is location decisions, the network planning process. Integrated logistics system is used by many firms with the help of information technology for tracking and coordinating the following functions effectively, that is material management, material flow systems and physical distribution. Volvo operates their warehouse in Memphis with the support of third-party suppliers. FedEx Logistics Services to handle stocks of truck parts. If a Volvo dealer needed a part in an emergency, phones a toll-free number and the part is flown out the same day and delivered that night at either the airport or the dealer's office. Then market logistics objectives. Situations where logistics plannings may go wrong, the traffic logistics manager favors rail shipment over air shipment because of the less rail cost. However, because the rail transport are slower, it ties up working capital longer, delay customer payment, and might cause customers to buy from competitors who offer faster service. The shipping department uses cheap containers to minimize shipping cost, and cheaper containers lead to a high rate of damaged goods. The inventory managers favors low inventory. This increases the possibility of stockouts, back orders, used paperwork, etc. Major objectives for any company logistics planning is on-time delivery, effectively meet emergency needs, careful handling of merchandise, and willingness to take back defective goods and resupply them quickly. Hope you all are satisfied with this session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. If you have any query, please mention it in a comment box. I will resolve them whenever we have a live session. Thank you so much for watching this video.